Both 1NC and 2NC stated how DACA keeps wages low. Well, actually, that's false because DACA increases wages by 42%. Study was made by Tom K. Wong, Associate Professor of Political Science, UC San Diego, Immigration Politics and Policy, posted on August 28, 2017. Last year's survey found that having DACA increased individuals' average hourly wages by more than 40%. The current survey data confirmed that DACA is having a positive and significant effect on wages. The average hourly wages of respondents increased by 42% since receiving DACA, rising from $9.83 per hour to $13.96 per hour. Further research is needed to parse out the short and long-run wage effects of DACA, as well as whether short-run gains represent a plateau in earnings, if an even more robust long-run wage effect exists as recipients gain more work and experience and progress in their careers. But for now, this much is clear. 4 years into the initiative, DACA means earning higher wages. So pretty much what this says is DACA has promoted employment outcomes and has been a major driver of economic growth for individuals and families, as well as cities and states that keep the benefits of new tax dollars from large purchases and new jobs. 4 years later, the effects of DACA on lives of unauthorized young people have been enormous, and we should all see this. Also, they stated that that they actually keeping DACA recipients cost us $50 million. Well, this statement is false also, because $50 billion in economic loss, we actually have a $50 billion economic loss if we deport DACA recipients. This is by Douglas Holtz Eakin, American economist and professor from, formerly economic professor, director of the Congressional Budget Office, September 6, 2017. Second, it is bad news for the economy. American Action Forum Benjitis pegs the total cost of ICE agents supporting all the potential DACA participants at about $50 billion and the economic cost as a loss of about 1% of real gross domestic product, or $175 billion in 2020. This quote demonstrates how deporting all DACA participants and sending them back to their country is not a solution. It's actually more expensive to deport the Dreamers than to keep them. Overall, there are more losses than gain if we withdraw DACA. I'm now open for cross-examination.
Excellent, but there's no cross-examination.
Not open.